actually yesterday. I was gonna put down, but that's just coincidence because I knew you were coming because I've had terrible trouble over the last couple of months with an adult acting, and it's been driving me bananas over the Christmas period, of course, when it felt worse, diminishing the alcohol and the chocolate and all the lolling around. Really enjoyed it. So I went in yesterday and I'm hoping it might actually boost and kickstart my skin for 2019. So
wonderful, because a lot of people tend to find that they get acne in their 20s, 30s, 40s, aggressive blackhead skin with teenagers. Someone's changed their skin in this way, acne, making it better. A lot of things can affect why we would get breakouts at this age.
All of the above, yeah.
But hydration is really good. But the thing is, right, I always compare skin care to a dentist. So what you do at home is 90% of that, but in my opinion, like brushing your teeth. You wouldn't go to the dentist and just have a good clean one beard except to have beautiful teeth. But it is important also to go and kind of have a treatment down for option as well. And hydration is a good one to get.
So I did the right thing, and I put the money down, and I did it, and I bought some products. I'm broke now, Jerry. But the thing is, it's important to look after your skin, and we've got a great question here, because when she was doing the facial with me yesterday, she said that I need to start wearing SPF because I'm 40 now, and I'm starting to get a few little spots and I was horrified. But this lady has said here, why should SPF be worn all year round? And actually, that's a question I'd like to know.
You're hoping you're going to live here. But daylight, even these kind of synthetic lights that we're using, which we use all the time, all of those lights have improved and have a negative impact on the skin. So it's important that we protect our skin. It is avoidance, it's supposed to be shielded and low from tail food, and that's where an SPF is. And then there's the other side of the debate about vitamin D. I'm not saying put SPF on because you don't think about vitamin D, but just put it on, that you put it on every single day to protect your skin. It only lasts up to the edge while it's on your skin, so it's just to give it that layer of protection.
What number should we put on?
So this was, I used to teach SPF class, which was 48 hours long, so it was 3 days